Welcome back to another Blockbench tutorial for your Steve model. Today I'll be talking a bit about how to make custom models. When you're making your first model from scratch, it can be a bit hard to know how tall it should be. One thing you can do is copy over the default head to your new project. This way you can get a feel of how tall it will be in Minecraft. But you can also scale the model later on. Something that might make it a bit easier for you to make your own models is having a reference picture to look at. You can add a picture to your workspace by going into View and pressing Edit Reference Images. Then you can press this icon to add a picture. The thing you should keep in mind when making a model is that everything you're going to animate should be grouped. The easiest way to start is by looking at how the default model is grouped. You don't necessarily need every group it has, but things like a group for the whole model and smaller groups for arms and legs are nice to have. Let's take a quick look at the arm group. As you can see, there are a lot of groups inside of it. This is because the arms have to be able to bend. You basically split the arm in half, so you have the forearm and the upper arm separated. And since the forearm is inside of the upper arm, they will move together. Another thing to remember is that you need to set the pivot points for the groups. This way they will rotate just the way you want. If you make a group called head, it will automatically rotate when you move your head inside of Minecraft. If you make a group called all head, the cubes inside of it will become invisible when you use the mod called first person model. For the first person model mod, you also need a group called view locator. It basically sets the height of the view. All locators are just empty groups, so you have to set the location for the pivot point. Some other locators you should add to your model by default are hand locators. They're called left hand locator and right hand locator. If you don't have hand locators, you won't be able to see the item you are holding. There are also shoulder locators for having a parrot sit on your shoulder. But since I don't tend to make wide shoulders, I put the shoulder locators inside of the head group. Just like the hand locators, the shoulder locators are called left shoulder locator and right shoulder locator. There is also an elytra locator. The elytra is the only piece of armor that has a locator. There are also a few more locators for the mods compatible with the Steve model. If you don't know which mods are compatible, you can check out this video. Anyway, if you want your model to be compatible with SlashBlade Resharped, you have to add some waist locators. Just like the hands and shoulder locators, they're called left waist locator and right waist locator. With these locators, you'll be able to carry a katana. For the mod called Timeless and Classic Zero, there are two locators. One is called pistol locator, and the other is called rifle locator. Basically, when you hold the weapon in your offhand, it will be shown at the pivot point of that locator. When you finish your model, you can export it as a bedrock geometry file called main.json. But you also need to make an arm.json file. To do this, you have to duplicate your model file and open it in a new tab. Then copy the arm group and delete the whole model. Then you have to paste the arm group and resolve the group so you have the right arm and the left arm. The arms have to point downwards, so you might need to rotate them a bit. Then move them closer together so they look kinda like this. And now you can export it as arm.json. And now all you have to do is just practice, 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 because you can definitely do it.